Ah. I think the main update for this video is the HitStops. So we now have that split second pause upon impact. I also have moves like the uppercut, the aerial attacks. I still have not edited the colliders for each of the animations yet, so you're gonna see funky results like this, but you know, more updates are coming. And you'll also notice that if I attack fast enough, I can sort of keep juggling the opponent. So that's a three-hit combo, sort of. There we go. So the opponent stayed in the air there for, I think, two consecutive hits. I also spent a lot of time recently refactoring some of the code. I think it's a lot more overall. The entire code is probably a lot more cleaner and more manageable than what I had in my previous devlog. I don't think I'm going to go through every detail, but here, this is the entire update for the fight scene. This is how the game works. We have things like checking collision between player to projectiles. We also have checking collision between players to players. We also create projectiles when necessary, the Hadouken move, for example. And finally, we update individual states and objects that are in the scene. You might also notice these scripts with the reaction name in them. So for projectile collision reaction, for example, this defines how the player reacts when he's hit by a projectile, like a Hadouken. If I look at the ground hits, for example, this defines how the player reacts when he gets hit while being on the ground. We delete the projectile. We also show effects. We transition the fighter to the next state called hit reaction. You're basically wincing. And then we finally go into the hit stop. So I've grouped up individual objects into several groups. We have fighters that are grouped together. Effects are grouped together. Projectiles are grouped together. And this means that we're pausing the fighter's update for 12 frames. We're also pausing projectile updates for 12 frames. The only difference between the ground hit and the mid-air hit is the jump. If you're hit while you're in the air, that sort of counts like an uppercut. You're launched into the air. And the jump specs define things like how far you go, how high you go, whether you have control or not. There are several types of jumps depending on how you define these parameters. Obviously, if you're on the ground and then you press up, that's a jump that you can control. You can hold the jump button, go higher, do a short press, do a quicker jump. The other types of jumps are where you're being launched into the air by being hit. That kind of jump is where you don't have control. So on the surface, there's things like launch and jump, but in the code, they're all jumps. You're just going up and then coming back down. I think another important aspect is controlling time. The hit stops. This is just done by a custom updater. I have things called the updater. Fighter's fixed updater is one example of an updater. An updater is just something, it's just a layer that stands between the game loop and the individual objects. And here I defined exactly when and how I want to do the updates. So whatever happens in the game loop, whenever the update happens, whatever happens, it gets filtered through a custom updater and down to the individual objects. So here I've defined the hit stop, for example. I have something called stop count in the updater. Whenever we have, this is just an integer, and whenever we have a stop count that's more than zero, we do the countdown. And while you're on the countdown, you don't do the updates until this goes back to zero, and then you're updating normally. And I could speed things up or slow things down. It just depends on how you want to define the updater. And it doesn't even matter what engine I'm using. For example, I have another Unity project. This is done in C#. It's completely different from my fighting game, but I'm using similar patterns here in terms of the updater and states and all that stuff. So I'm dead here. I have something called the placer updater. So it's the same idea, just in different language on a different engine. The placer refers to how you place or spawn enemies. So here I have defined my updater. In this case, I'm not even using time or frames. This updater is based on the distance that the player covers. So whenever a player covers 10 meters, for example, that's when we run the update for the placer, and that's when we spawn an enemy in this case. So it could be anything. You could speed things up, slow things down. The updater doesn't even have to be based on time or the main game loop or anything. It's just how you define it. And I think I've also had several questions from Unity users on things like controlling time, slowing down, speeding things up, controlling individual time for individual objects. A lot of the questions were misplaced or misguided. Questions like, what Unity asset do I need to control time? Or what Unity feature or function do I use to control time? Well, it's really more about how you define it, and it pretty much comes down to the basics. How much do you understand OOP? How much can you write your own structures and patterns and make things modular and manageable? So it just comes down to, again, the basics and how you define it. So it's up to you, really. There is no Unity feature that's going to fit your game perfectly. Whatever you use, you're probably going to use. You're probably going to write your own layer on top of something, or make a bridge or something. Do whatever. It's going through your own code, and how you define your own code is up to you. So I think the fighting game is going pretty well. The development is going pretty well, I think. I can also control overall time, slow it down, speed it up, you know, do whatever. Again, it's up to you to decide how you want to define your own code. I still have a lot of things to do. I still need to update the colliders to match the animations better. I haven't decided exactly what I'm going to do next week, but stuff that I can think of right now are things like the HP bars. I might need more moves, more combos. I might also need more dynamic camera movement, because right now camera movement is completely based on my manual controls on the keyboard. So I might need to add those things before I can even call this a prototype. And I'll decide as I go. So that's pretty much it for this video. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. All the links are in the description. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.